Today's scientists need access to sophisticated computing power. What if there was a way to put spare computing power at a university to good use by making it available to others? If we can pool this computing power together, we will be able to speed up research work. That's exactly what the European grid infrastructure does with the grid. This network of computer servers at universities across Europe supports a wide range of cutting-edge research. Welcome to Stories from the Grid. In this episode, May Belt Comets. Astronomers always believed that comets came from the outer reaches of our solar system. Until recently, when they discovered objects that looked like comets with a tail of water vapor and dust. Only they were observed in the main belt. The main belt is part of the inner solar system, between Mars and Jupiter, much closer to Earth, and is normally filled with rocky asteroids. Astronomers suspect that the ice, now visible in main belt comets, may have been the source of the water on Earth. The grid lended a helping hand in finding out more about main belt comets and their ice.
Scientists believe that during its formation, water was not incorporated in our planet, but it was brought later, probably by asteroids or maybe comets. However, the, let's say, usual comets don't have the exact type of the water that we find at the Earth.
Could the water on Earth have been delivered by main belt comets? For that to happen, the water now observed in these comets should have been present in the main asteroid belt for a long time. Bojan and his colleagues have a theory for what happened.
So we have a lot of asteroids orbiting around the Sun between Mars and Jupiter. During the collision in the main asteroid belt, when one object hits another one, the target object is very often fragmented in many small pieces. So such a collision brings deeply buried ice from inside the objects at the surface or close to the surface. This ice, located at the surface, disappear very quickly on the time scale of 1,000 years. However, the ice below the surface is able to remain there for some time. Later on, smaller impacts by meter-sized impactors are relatively frequent. These impacts bring the ice below the surface on the surface. And then solar heating causing the evaporation or sublimation of this ice, and actually what as a result of this we see cometary-like activity on these objects.
To find out if this model was holding up, the astronomers reconstructed what happened after the large impact between asteroids. Could the remaining fragments be pieced together back in time?
We simply try to reconstruct the orbits of nearby asteroids in order to try to show that they all originated from single collision, from one larger parent body. To show that these objects came together once in the past, we need to use a lot of the so-called orbital clones. They represent all possible past solutions of these objects. We produce these clones on one side for all asteroids, all potential members of the family, and what is even more important, for our main belt comet.
So these orbital clones can be seen as possible variations on the actual orbits. Bojan performed intensive calculations to find out which variations fit reality best.
Using the grid, we can increase the number of objects that we follow back in time. We can increase the time that these objects are tracked. So in this way, we can get more reliable conclusions. We were able to link this main belt comet to an associated asteroid family.
So to wrap it all up, astronomers observed several objects in the main belt that looked like a comet. They believed that these comets were in fact asteroids, with ice in their cores that had been present there since the early solar system. The astronomers suspected that this ice was brought to the surface of these asteroids in a sequence of large and small collisions. To prove that this actually happened, they needed to find a link between asteroid families and main belt comets. One way to do this is by retracing the orbits of the fragments back to a larger parent body. The grid was used to calculate the best fit for all possible orbits of the asteroid fragments. This way they were able to conclude that the main belt comet they researched belonged to an asteroid family, and that ice has indeed been buried in asteroids for as long as the solar system exists.
In the future, we expect more computational power from the grid, apart from these single links between families and main belt comets. We are planning to work on a bigger picture to estimate, for example, the amount of ice present in the main asteroid belt today, to estimate the number of main belt comets, and also to see whether we can get any conclusion about the possibility that some of these objects hit the Earth in the past.
Want to see how the grid can be useful in other fields of research? Then join us next time for another episode of Stories from the Grid.